Hello guys, this is the Gaming Whistle back again with another video. In today's video, I have something special for you guys, and I'm going to be covering where to farm every single Warframe up to today, January 20th of 2021. So farming every single Warframe in the game and where to find them. So in alphabetical order, we're going to start off with Ash. Ash's blueprint is purchased from the market, and his parts are obtained by killing Grineer Mannix, which look like this, and you have a 33% chance of getting a part from them. The best place to go to actually get Mannix to definitely spawn is Tyler Regor, which is on Titania near Uranus, so you can go there. There's a guaranteed, I think, two of them spawning, so that's a 66% chance, I guess, so good luck. Ash is pretty difficult to farm in my opinion, but not that hard. There's definitely Warframes that are a little bit, you know, harder to farm than him. Then, moving on to Atlas. Atlas is gained by doing the Jordis Verdict or Precept quest. His blueprint is gained from here. And his parts are gained by killing the Jordis Golem on Ares. So go to Ares and the Jordis Golem is right here. You gain his parts from there. Moving on to Banshee. Banshee's parts are available in the Clan Dojo alongside the blueprint, I think. But no, actually the blueprint's in the Warframe market. Now, Baruch. Baruch is purchased from Lil Duck at 5,000 standing, of course, that is in a Venus Fortuna. And you can gain all of his parts by getting, so above Agent rank, which I actually forgot the name of, so sorry about that. You can purchase all of his parts from there, and they cost 5,000 standing, so in total, 20,000 standing with them. Moving on to Chroma. Chroma is obtained by completing the New Strange quest, his blueprint of course. So completing the New Strange quest, if I can find it, there you go, you get his blueprint, and his parts are gained by, of course, going on to Saturn and going on to Uranus Junction. You will get the Near Optics here, then Neptune Junction on Uranus, you will get yourself his chassis, if it were to show a little bit faster, and on Pluto Junction on Neptune, you will get his systems. So that's pretty easy and pretty easy to get him, not very difficult at all. I will not be showing you how to get the quests. They're pretty much, I guess, junction rewards, so nothing much to explain here, to be perfectly honest with you. Ember is obtained by killing the Saturn boss, which I kind of forgot the name of, so he is right here on Tethys, so keep that in mind. It's pretty easy to get them, and of course her blueprint is purchasable from the market. Equinox is gained by killing Tyle Regor on Uranus. Now, you need to make sort of two versions of Equinox. You need to make a day and a night version, so virtually you're crafting two Warframes, and then you need to combine them into one. So, yeah, that's gonna take you a little bit more time. Then moving on to Mars and killing Lieutenant Leech Krill, if I'm correct, on War. You will get Excalibur's parts, and going on to, let me just remember real quick, for Frost, you will go on to Ceres to kill Lieutenant Leech Krill and Captain War right here. Their blueprints are purchasable from the market, of course. Now, completing the Vox Solaris quest will grant you Gerudo's blueprint, which is right here, not Vox, but Vox Solaris quest, and her parts are gained by completing bounties in the Orb of Alice, which is on Venus. Moving on to Goss, his parts are gained from tier 3 disruption missions, so Kelpion Sedna is going to be the best option for you, so go on to Sedna and go on to Kelpie, if I can find it, there it is. And doing that disruption mission will allow you to get his parts. Now, Grendel, you can purchase locator beacons from, I guess, the arbitration vendor in the Red Veil Syndicate, or the Steel Meridian Syndicate. I think I said that right. But his blueprint is purchased from the market. You will get those beacons. You will virtually find him. Let me just see. Orbiter of Hexes. There you go. That's what I wanted to say. Not the Steel Meridian. That's where you can get the beacons, and the blueprint is purchased from the market. Once you do those beacons, you will get his parts virtually, and then you can craft the actual Warframe. Now, moving on to Hero. Hero's blueprint is obtained by completing the Chains of Heroes quest, which, honestly, I have to say, is one of the best and awesomest quests in the game. I love this quest. It spooked the hell out of me. A really awesome quest, but his blueprint is obtained here. Then moving on to his parts. His chassis is available from Void Tracer's enemies. You have, I think, a 3% chance of getting them, but you just have to do any kind of Void mission, I mean, Neolith or Oxy Relic mission, and pretty much you're gonna get it. And then the Neuroptics are gained from going to the Kuva Fortress, and going on to Pego, doing the spy mission there, and then getting the systems is going to be a rotation B and C defection mission. And these missions are very difficult, and I do not like them at all. I think defection missions you can play on Sedna, if I'm correct. I mean, you can look around a little bit where to find defection missions. You probably already know, because to gain some of these quests, you will need to complete some missions around the star chart. So yeah, you can search around for that, but I think any sort of defection mission will work. Now moving on to Hildra, her blueprint is purchased from Little Duck on Venus, of course, Fortuna, for 5,000 standing at agent rank, and her parts are gained by killing the Exploiter Orb on Venus, of course. Then Hydroid will be defeating the boss on Earth, which is on Oro. So this is Void, I mean, his name is Vahek Terraframe, so this is an annoying mission to actually do. I really didn't like farming for my Hydroid, just because it's an annoying mission, but nonetheless, that's where you get him. Now, moving on to Inaros, and Inaros is gained by doing the Tombs of Inaros quest. Oh, sorry, Sands of Inaros quest. And this is purchasable from Void Trader when he comes around every second Friday for 100 ducats and 100,000 credits, if I remember correctly, and I'm pretty sure I do. Now, moving on to Ivara. Ivara is gained by doing spy missions, going on to Lua, doing the spy mission on there. Let me just show you, where is it? Pavlov will grant you the chassis. The blueprint and the Neuroptics are gained by doing 26 and above level missions, so spy missions. And then systems is going to be doing level 1 to 15 spy missions. Then moving on to Korra. Korra is gained by doing Sentry Onslaught, the normal one, not the elite one. At rotation A, you have the chassis. At the rotation B, you have the Neuroptics. And rotation C, you have the blueprint and the systems. And of course, if I didn't mention... Yeah, never mind, I mentioned everything. Lavos is gained by going on to Deimos and going on to Necros, buying it from Father. I did release a video a couple days ago. Then Limbo and his parts and his blueprint and everything is gained by doing the quest Limbo Theorem. You can get that pretty easily. Loki is going to be killing the Hyena Pack on Neptune. Then getting yourself Mesa and Mag real quick, going on to Phobos and killing the boss there. So I think it's on Iliad. There you go. Killing Sergeant will give you Mag's supports, and of course Loki and Mag parts blueprints will be able to purchase from the market. So keep that in mind. Getting Mesa is going on to Eris, defeating Mutalist Alad V, and you get those coordinates by doing invasions, as you can see. Mutalist Alad V, nav coordinate, and then you will craft them into one coordinate and kill them there, and her blueprint is purchasable from the market. Mirage and her parts are gained by doing the Hidden Messages quest, so going here, and then completing the Hidden Messages will give you all of her parts, including her blueprint. Then Necros is going to be obtained by going on to Deimos and killing on Lefantis. Pretty easy to do. Pretty good Warframe, in my opinion. Neja is going to be obtained by going to the Clan Dojo and getting her from there. And then Nidus, his blueprint is going to be by completing the Glass Gambit quest. Let me just show you that real quick. So doing this will give you the blueprint. Now, getting yourself the parts, you need to play Infested Salvage, and you will gain his parts in rotation C. All you need to do is go on to Ares and go on, let me just tell you, Oestrus. This is the mission, and you will gain Nidus' parts from there. Now, going on to Europa, killing the Raptors will give you Nova's parts, if I can find where the boss is. Apparently, I cannot seem to find where the boss is. It is somewhere around here. I'm really dedicated to actually finding it this time. Last time it was. Hey, there you go. There you go. It's Namah, which is the mission's name. Now, getting Nessus Spores is going to be killing the Forid boss, which is an invasion boss. He comes around, so on and so on. For example, he's going to be on Saturn, and you can kill him for Nyx's ports, and her blueprint is obtained by purchasing it from the market, which is great. Moving on to Oberon. His blueprint is purchased from the market, and his ports are gained by killing Eximus enemies. You have a 1% chance, which is pretty good, but considering there's a lot of them, it's not going to be that hard for you to obtain him. Moving on to Octavia. Her blueprint is obtained by doing Octavia's Anthem quest. Her chassis is available by doing Lulu music puzzle, which looks something like this. Which what you need to do is jump inside of these tubes, the green one that have the green circle around them, and then jump up and up and up and up until you get to the very top, and then you have a chance of getting her chassis. The Neuroptics is doing on Deimos Survival, which is Aetherium. Or Aetherium, I think what it's called. Yeah, there you go. At C rotation, and our systems are doing the Lua Crossfire mission, which is Plateau, pretty easy, and it's an A rotation mission, so pretty plain and simple. Now, Protea, her blueprint is gained by doing the Deadlock Protocol. No, not. Yes, the Deadlock Protocol, that's what it's called. So, blueprint is obtained from here, and what you need to do for her parts is get these Granum Void coins. You get them by, after playing a certain mission inside of the new and redesigned of Corpus spaceships like these on Mercury and Venus. Sorry, just on Venus. And of course, you have some on Jupiter and any sort of mission that has, what's it called, Corpus on them, they are redone. And depending on the level of mission that you play, you will get different kinds of Granum coins. These enemies will spawn and they will blink red like capture targets do. And then you will get a Granum Void coin from them. And at that point, you will be able to use that coin. And I'm just going to show you right here. As you can see, there's a golden hand there. And you see a little console there. Going into that, putting your coin in, will transport you into the Granum's Void. And here, virtually use Mesa. Kill everything you possibly can and do get as many kills as you possibly can. At tier 1 you will get the Neuroptics, tier 2 chassis, and tier 3 you will get the systems. Then moving on to Revenant. Revenant is gained by doing the Mask of the Revenant. Oh, sorry. Let me just try to find it. I'm just going to type in Mask. There you go. Mask of the Revenant mission, quest, you will gain the blueprint, and the parts are gained by doing the actual bounties on Plains of Eidolon. Of course, you can gain Garrus parts from doing bounties in the Plains of Eidolon as well. Then we're gonna quickly move on to Rhino. Rhino is gained by killing the Jackal on Venus, which is, I always forget this mission, but killing the Jackal will give you Rhino, which you probably already know. There you go, Arfosa, because he is one of the best four, you know, Warframes to actually start with. Killing Killer the Fem will give you Saren's ports, and of course Rhino, and of course Saren's blueprints can be obtained by going into the market. Now, we're gonna move on to Titania. Now, this is one of the most boring quests you can possibly play in the game. This, you actually have to scan flowers. It's called the Silver Grove. You get gain all of her parts here, by the way, and it's not the best quest. It's interesting, but not very fun. So yeah, going on to Pluto and killing the boss there, you will get Trinity's parts, and her blueprint, of course, is burstable from the actual market. And the mission is called Hades. So going here and killing the bosses here will give you Trinity's parts. Moving on to Jupiter and killing Aladvi on Themisto will give you Valkyr's ports and her blueprint, of course, from the market. Voban is obtained by doing Nightwave missions like these right here, weekly missions, gaining credits and going into the credit offerings and purchasing his ports for 25 credits each, and of course his blueprint from the market. Moving on to Volt, he is available in the Clan Dojo, his blueprint in the market. And then moving on to Wisp is going to be going on to Pluto and killing the Ripper Rawlist. I did that on purpose, by the way. I'm joking, it didn't. Killing the Repelolist on Pluto will award you the Wisps' parts and every single thing you can possibly get, along with the blueprint. Zaku is obtained by doing the Heart of Deimos quest, and his parts are available by doing bounties on the Heart of Deimos, which is right here, as you can see the quest. You gain blueprint and his parts from doing bounties, and Zephyr is going to be last but definitely not least, didn't say that with some hesitation, can be purchased from the Clan Dojo. I'm just going to check, I think I covered every single Warframe I possibly can. I'm definitely sure I did. So that has been me. That has been everything I could possibly say and, you know, tell you where to farm every single Warframe. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys did, leave a like, a comment, and subscribe. I definitely enjoyed making this video. It's quite fun, even though it didn't sound like that because I'm very thirsty at the moment for talking, I don't know, maybe like 12, 15 minutes. But yeah, I'm really happy if it helped you to farm some Warframes. If it did, leave a like, a comment, and subscribe. It will be greatly appreciated. And I will see you guys on the next one. The Gaming Weasel over and out.